back inside from the outside excursion with young Chris. And it looks like another new day. Yeah, the next morning. What is that angle? Oh my god. I am at the neighbors.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, come on.
The kid never listens.
He's breaking the rules all the time. I mean, I'm happy for him that he can make a friend his age, but he does not understand the severity of the situation. No, yeah, we can't do anything else. Our bag is there, or another bag, I should say. Let's go.
Claire? Steven? Anybody home?
I guess nobody's home. That's why Daniel thought he could get away with it.
Looks like I'm home alone.
All right. What does that mean for us? What's our objective here? Go get Daniels at the Erickson's, okay? We've got another new journal entry as well. What the hell, Daniel? The first fucking rule. What was that kid running away from, and did his father see something? Ah, that's the other thing I didn't consider.
Right. Sunday morning. Claire and Steven must be at church.
Oh, okay. Oh, and they set up the tree!
We had a good time decorating the tree together last night. Daniel loved it.
This is it! Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I don't know if I feel comfortable about this. Something's gonna happen over at the neighbor's house. They're gonna be gone.
Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours.
Morning, sleepyheads. We let you sleep in today while we're at church. Back by noon for lunch. See you in a bit. Love, Grandma and Grandpa. P.S. The Christmas tree is perfect. Good job, kids. P.S.S. Thank you for tidying up a bit. Hey, there we go.
Maybe I could use Steven's laptop.
Oh.
It's been ages since I've had news from the real world.
Is that... Are we gonna break the rules? No. No. We're a good kid. We're a good kid. We're not going to use the laptop. It'd be dangerous. We need to go get our little brother.
Okay. Let's get this brat back home now.
Daniel does not listen. I wonder how the father
felt. Move your ass. Who knows what Daniel's doing over there?
That's exactly what I am doing.
Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm too soft with him.
I'm running as fast as I can, dude.
Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait, don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things, objects, with my mind.
Oh, a superpower. Really?
Yes.
Pretty cool.
Well, that's pretty cool, Chris. So, you're like a superhero?
I'm Captain Spirit. I can bend any matter to my will. But that's my secret identity, so you can't tell anybody.
Oh, I can keep a secret, Captain Spirit.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh, yeah, we need a team signal.
Totally. I'm gonna be Super Wolf.
Oh, good lord.
What's your super name, Sean?
Please pick a cool one. El Diablo Loco? Or Silver Runner? Good lord. I do not want to have Blow in my superhero name. El Diablo Loco. It's gotta be the Silver Runner. Oh, man.
How about the Silver Runner? Cool? Cool, right?
Not bad. That's true, you're a great runner.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll.
What?
Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah. They share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations! And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
I mean, we got $15! How are we gonna buy Christmas presents? Ah, this is so bad! This is so awkward, me just standing here, not being able to make a decision. Dude, we're not supposed to go in public. They'll worry. They'll worry.
Well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
We won't be gone for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean. I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes. Please. Please. Please.
Okay. You win. Not a fair fight. So let's go.
Yes! Yeah!
See?
All right.
Dangerous.
It's unavoidable.
Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends. And his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Oh, I know. Insectozoid is a villain. Well, Power Bear's a hero. Easy.
You sure?
Of course. Insectozoid is a villain. The dinosaur doesn't matter. The car doesn't matter. Warrior is a hero. And...
careful.
Dinosaur's
it may
a villain.
Be tricky.
The bear is a hero, and then the car is a villain.
Interesting.
I think I got it. I think I got it. Wait, the plane. Plane is a... no, not Insectozoid. Oh, no, the plane's not there. Okay.
Okay. How did I do?
Not bad. You're almost right. It was a bit tricky. Okay, let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit, the good guys. There's the Forest Warrior, Power Bear, Marty Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. But they're all working for Mantroid, who's the real supervillain.
So, where is he?
Hiding out on his evil planet, waiting for me. But Captain Spirit and Super Wolf will make sure he doesn't hurt anyone.
Yeah. Strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah. About that.
Does your father know? Yeah, we gotta tie up all the loose ends here.
Does your dad know about any of this? Did he... see something yesterday?
No, he didn't see anything, and the power didn't work yesterday. After I fell. Must have been too tired.
Okay, good. I mean, he could be pretty disturbed if he knew.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't wanna freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Understandable. Is everything cool with him? Yeah, I want to get to the bottom of this. This is where we're going.
Chris, it's none of my business, but are you and your dad okay?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Claire seems to be worried about you guys. Yesterday, she told Steven about those bruises on your arm. I think they had a talk with Charles about it.
Claire's always worried. We're cool. Totally. He has a hard time being on his own. That's all.
Okay. That's about as good an answer as we can get from a 9-year-old kid. I understand. It's gonna be okay. We gotta reassure the little dude.
Chris, I know life can get pretty tough. Trust me. But you'll be okay. You're an awesome kid.
Thanks, Sean. But I don't feel scared anymore. I have the power, and I have Daniel.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip. Don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad. Let's roll. All
right, well, Daniel dominated their bathroom with a power dump, apparently.
You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right. Jeez.
He is a little shit, and he's gonna get us in so much trouble. All right, Chris, it's just you and me in the cabin of this truck here. We're gonna get down to some questions here, I imagine. I can't believe we're leaving the house. I'm glad I didn't have to say yes or no. I'm glad that this is where the story was going anyway, because I would have said no. I would have been that guy. Okay. Beaver Creek is a small town. Everybody's gonna be talking. If Claire only knew that Daniel was riding in the back of a truck with a cold, like, she would not be happy. Oh, God. Howdy. You know, we're just a squadron of four going to pick up a Christmas tree. There's a dog! It's a cool-looking dog. Hey, look at all these trees.
Okay, buddy. You ready?
Yeah. Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure.
But
don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Chris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Oh, another choice so quickly? Protect the secret or stop lying to Chris. You have to protect the secret, dude. Because we can't stop lying to Chris. What does that mean? Stop lying to Chris means that we tell him that it's Daniel's power. But you have to keep the secret, dude.
Listen, I understand, but we have to be extra careful out here. You can't let people see you. You know the rules.
Yes, I know the rules. But I'm careful. I only do things when it's me and Chris. Nobody sees us.
Yeah, nobody but me. What if it was Chris's dad? Or grandma? Or a cop? or...
Okay, okay. I get it. But I'm careful.
That's not enough. You have to be extra, extra careful.
All right. I swear I will.
Deal. I'm counting on you, Anano.
Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
Yeah, you and your weird face paint can go see your friend. Okay.
Wow. So many trees.
I thought you wanted to go see Chris. Well, we already have a tree, ugh. So...
They look like giant cocoons. Creepy. You coming, Sean?
Don't worry. I'll be around.
I'm here. Care spray. Yeah, I don't want to talk to people. There's a tree wrapper.
Nothing. I'll tell you later. So, what do?
We have to pick the one we like. Can Daniel help, Dad?
Of course he can.
Awesome. Come on, no time to lose.
Okay, just pick the one you like and come get me. Deal?
Deal.
I've never been on such a dangerous mission.
Yeah, these wild trees are just waiting to eat us.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Are you serious? Oh, Charles. We get to talk with him? Yeah, I guess we will.
Hey.
Hey, Sean. What's up?
Just wanted to thank you for bringing us out here.
Hey, no problem. I hope you'll find what you're looking for. It's kind of a tiny place.
It's perfect. Don't worry.
Yeah, I sure need it. It's not an easy task with this guy. Come get me when you're done.
I will.
All right, we're a people guy. You know, we got to keep the peace here. This gentleman is just standing over here. We got some trees over here.
I wonder what will happen to the trees no one buys.
Strong tree to protect our base from evil elves.
Oh, that was a squirrel! Yo, look at this squirrel in the middle here. Alright, what's up, guys?
Let's look at another one.
Am I seriously?
Okay. Better find a gift for Daniel quick. While he's still busy with Chris.
Ooh, oh, okay.
This one is cool.
Find
I agree.
A gift.
Adding it to the-
find Daniel a Christmas present. Well, I'm gonna need to go out over here, I would imagine. Yeah, look at this. We got like a little craft fair going on over here. Facing the whole panel.
Hi. Everything all right?
All good.
Quiet donation box.
As usual.
Good.
Ah, here we go. Gifts. Pick one.
We only sell handmade local products. Come take a look.
Yeah, I will. Don't you worry. Food. Do you have what do I do with this food? Come on. I can only look at it. Okay. Let me pick a gift for Daniel here. We've got $15 and we need to buy Daniel a Christmas gift, and Claire and Steven one. I guess we'll buy Daniel a snowman.
Deals in Beaver Creek.
We'll buy Daniel the snowman, and then we'll buy Claire and Steven a wreath. Okay, so we have the snowman. And then we have Christmas wreaths here.
Better keep my cash for Daniel first.
The best Christmas wreaths are here. Okay. Decorate your front doors with something truly special.
Wooden signs. All right, I guess we'll talk
hey.
To you.
Hi.
Good morning, young man. It's nice to see a new face in this old town.
Thanks. It's a super cool market you got here.
Small towns are the best for Christmas. Who are you staying with?
Uh-oh. The Reynolds? Uh-oh. Reynolds.
The Reynolds?
Everybody knows Steven. He was Beaver Creek's fire chief years ago. You're not his grandson, are you?
Ah! Just a family friend, sir! Ah! Oh, man. Just a family friend.
Oh, no. He's just an old family friend.
Gotcha. Anyway, welcome to Beaver Creek. If you need anything, just holler.
Yeah, I need to buy.
We only sell handmade local products. Come take a look.
How do I check out? Poster, table, sit and draw. Oh, yeah. Okay, we'll sit and draw. And then we need to pick out the wreath. Who do I buy from then? The woman? That's the only thing I could think of. Because we just talked with the dude.
Cool. I think I'm ready to draw this.
Oh man, I really should have said that we were his grandson, but we gotta keep a low profile. Alright, now let's get these drawings done here.
Time to take the pen, dude.
We're becoming a drawing professional here.
This place is nice.
Okay, let's finish the drawing, dude. We don't want people to think we're stealing stuff.
Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want.
Look at all this detail we're adding.
Nope. I can't do anything without looking up first.
Look at that. We'll even have the detail on the table here. The coffee cup.
What are you drawing? Whoa, it's so cool. Are you like a professional?
Nah, more like the opposite.
You could draw comic books. The awesome adventures of Captain Spirit and Super Wolf.
Pretty rad for a Hollywood name. Yeah. I'll think about it.
Hey, can you add something funny to your drawing?
Funny? Like what?
I don't know. Something cool.
Okay. Big question. Zombies or UFO?
We'll do a UFO.
What about a giant spaceship flying over Beaver Creek?
How about that? Oh, I have to look up and observe it. Oh wait, Daniel's in the thing. There we go. Okay. Look at that.
I hope I can draw like you one day.
I'm sure you will, man.
That's a cool little drawing we got there. Ladies and gentlemen. All right. Now we need to pay for Daniel's gift. Do we pay for...
Did I leave the shop yesterday?
This is a nice collection.
Why, thank you. I make them all myself.
Whoa. Must be a lot of work.
Definitely too much for the money they get me, yes.
How come?
How come?
Well, people certainly don't buy as much handmade Christmas decorations as they used to. The mall has ruined every single shop in town. Can't do anything about it, and people seem surprised unemployment is going through the roof.
Oh, yeah. I see.
I know. It sucks. But we can't do anything about it. Right?
I like to think there's always a solution, however frustrating that thought can be. Anyway, you've got better things to do than listening to an old lady ranting about capitalism, right?
It's cool. Don't worry.
Well, thanks for hearing me out anyway. You have a nice day.
You too. I hope things turn around for you.
Better keep my cash for Daniel first.
I already did. Where do we... I don't...
You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
Okay, so I guess I need to go buy that over here? Maybe? I don't know where else to buy it. Oh, shit. This is a singer. I didn't even notice her over here. Give money, or can we talk with her? Listen. Hey, what's up?
It's me, you've come to take my duality. Wakes the midnight time I could not see. If I were you, were you, or me, we play the game skillful hands, and so I asked for your demands. streets, I found a way, I found a way to reappear. Wow, you made it all the way through. Weird.
Weird?
You got a crush on me or something?
What? No, I mean, it was pretty cool. I just...
Relax, dude. It's cool that you listened. People are usually too busy to care.
Great voice.
You have a great voice. You should be on one of those singing shows.
That's kind of nice. Not really my thing, though. I hate TV and show business shit.
Well, thanks for the music. And good luck.
See ya.
Well, I feel bad because we've got to give her some money. Yeah, we'll give her some money. We won't be able to buy a gift for Claire and Steven, but
hey.
It's not much, but she probably needs it more than
me
right now.
Anyone?
Did your guitar just disappear? I think it did. Is there anything else we could do? Oh no, we can talk with her now.
Hey.
Hey. Miss me already?
What? No, I mean...
I'm just messing with you. It's nice to chat for a change. Me and my friends have been crashing here for the week. Nobody gives a shit about us. Yeah, I can tell you're not from around here.
No way.
No way. Just... here for the holidays.
Ah. You got family.
My grandparents.
Gotta love the grandparents.
What about you and your friends? Road trip?
Not really. We kinda hop from place to place, hunting for little jobs.
Must be a long ride.
That's okay. We hop on trains. Gives us time to rest.
Man, that sounds wicked.
You have no idea. It's free and so fucking fun. Well, unless you get caught or fall, but we've been lucky so far. That's the best. Nobody tells us what to do. No corporation owns us.
And you get to see so many cool places.
Exactly. Next stop is Humboldt County, California.
Stoner break.
Not even close. We actually got work over there.
Sean, what are you doing? We picked the tree with Chris. It's all crooked like an old witch. Oh, hi. Who are you? Ooh, your hair looks so cool. Is it a wig?
Well...
Dude.
What do you think?
I don't know, but it's really cool. I'm Daniel. What's your name?
Hi, Daniel. I'm Cassidy. I dig your superhero outfit.
I'm on a secret mission with my friend. It's very dangerous.
I can tell. I hope you get your mission accomplished. And what's your name?
Oh, Sean. I thought I told you.
No, you did.
Sorry, you went through some shit with the guys. How much you make? You ready?
He's got the dog!
Hello, pups.
Ooh, is that your doggy? So cool.
Yeah, he's been through a lot. Like most of us. So we adopted him. And he stinks! Yeah, you stink and you like it, huh?
He's not the only one.
Have you checked your hair? I think it just twitched. You should keep your distance, dude.
She looks cool.
She looks really cool, I think.
See? He knows I'm clean. You're the nasty one.
Yeah, you always go for those suburban boys.
Are you kidding? You want to talk about your scoreboard, hotshot?
Hey, no worries.
Come on, let's bail.
It was nice meeting you, Sean and Daniel.
Stay out of trouble,
goodbye.
Kids.
Hope we see you on the rails someday.
Yeah. See you around.
Dottie was so cute. I miss Mushroom.
I miss her too.
Hey, excuse me. Dogs have to be on a leash around here. Too many strays.
Sorry, dude. We don't do leashes.
Well, the city does. An unleashed dog is liable to a fine, so...
You're gonna fine our dog? Well, that's not very nice.
Loitering is illegal, too. And you don't live here, right? Right?
Calm down, sweetie. We're allowed to visit the Christmas market. Our dog's not gonna eat you. Look at him.
You better watch your mouth. You punks are always causing trouble. This is a nice town, okay?
Jeez. Someone needs to get laid.
He's out of pills.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, God. He's gonna call the cops on us, Finn.
Chill out. We're leaving this shithole anyway. You guys don't even have a Santa, for Christ's sake.
Merry Christmas.
Fucking parasites.
Why did they fight? I don't get why he yelled like that. We should kick his ass, Sean.
What? Dude, you little shit. Prank him or drop it. All right, you can prank him.
See the snow on that booth?
Yeah. What about it?
Maybe this guy needs a shower. You know? To cool him down.
You're right.
Oh, you're going to get the...
Hold on.
Careful.
Oh, he's going to get the pedestrians too,
careful.
Though.
Careful.
This will teach them.
Nice.
Come on.
What was that? He looked right at us and went, oh my God. I need to get out of here, okay? Can I please pay for my thing? Dude, I need to pay for this.
We only sell handmade local products. Come take a look.
Wait a minute, didn't I? I thought I picked one. Pick the snowman. Back. And do I have it? Oh, I see. I need to pick the snowman and then talk to the vendor.
You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
Got it. Okay, well, we'll pick a snowman.
I'd like one of those snowman things.
Of course. They're handmade by local kids.
Cool.
We'll pay. We'll buy it.
Here you go.
Thanks. Anything else?
No. I'm good.
Have a nice day, then.
Yeah, you too. Thanks.
Okay.
Cool. Mission accomplished. We better leave now, before Claire and Steven come back.
Okay, so we bought a gift for Daniel. Now, can we buy a gift for Claire and Steven? Oh, the Christmas market. Oh, that was the new spot we were at. Okay. This is a submarine and a little action figure for Daniel. And for us, we don't have anything else. I don't know where that thing we just bought is now. We don't have enough to buy the wreath, though.
Shit.
Welcome,
definitely
kid.
Not my budget.
Hit me up if you want anything.
Oh. Excuse me? Can you spare a dollar? Where's that, I'll catch you a dollar guy? Or I caught you a dollar from State Farm. We could really use that dollar. Oh, a Christmas card.
Hi, everybody. We're taking a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now. Hope you're doing well.
I want to buy a small gift for Claire and Steven, but I guess the only gift I could buy for them would be a Christmas wreath, but we don't have enough now.
Each of our wreaths is unique. Special price if
you
buy two.
Sorry, lady. I don't have enough cash. Too rich for my blood. We need to go. Heading on out. Going back. Hey guys, what's up?
Hey, you guys ready to go?
Yeah. All done.
Cool. Hop in.
Okay. Just a short drive back.
Are you having too much fun back there?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
All right, just a short drive back to the grandparents' house. Well, to Charles and Chris's house. And then we'll go back over to Grandma and Grandpa's. They're probably going to be pissed that we were out. Because I'm sure they're going to know one way or another. I don't know. I think the gift that we bought, though, was for Daniel. So that probably won't go to Steven and Claire. But at the very least, we bought a gift for somebody. So we still got $9 left. It's better than nothing. But still wish we had a little bit more.